5 minutes, so I've got to do some edits real quick. Actually, I planned on winging it anyway. I wasn't sure what anybody else was saying. And, what would strike me after watching pictures again, which I watched at least 10 times last night after I put it together, so I should know what I'm going to say. I've been exposed to missions my entire life. Growing in church, I went at least no less than 3 times a week. So anytime the missionaries were in town, we had the usual show, like everybody else went through, and then we had them over for dinner or lunch or whatever. So I always had a different connection to it, I would say. But I had no concept what I was going to do. And I was very excited to go on the trip. And God said that it could go because it's not something physically I've been able to do for the last decade. And then I almost backed out when I saw that I'd wear a skirt for the conservative mission that we were at. And I literally said, you can forget it, take the money, go. I'm not wearing a skirt for anybody. Those of you ladies that were here last the other week, you'll remember I'm a little rebellious. So it took me about 5 minutes to get over to realize there's something greater to come out of this than my pride about wearing an ugly skirt. And I'm so glad I did. Now, I have many, many experiences I can share with you. Riding in the truck, I have many bruises. My whole left side of my leg is purple from swaying into the side of the truck as you go through the mountain. But I wouldn't have traded that either, because to be able to see the countryside and the vantage point that we had, to be able to see everything that was going on, was priceless. Going to the market, the one day that they asked us to go to the market, being able to trade and bargain with them for their fruits and their vegetables, I felt like I'd always been there. The children were probably what touched my heart the most. In fact, I found ways to ditch work so I could play with the kids. I felt like that was why I was there. That was one of the key things I prayed about going on this trip, was being able to connect with the children. And to have them, to just be standing anytime your arms were loose by your side, to have several of them slip up and put their hands into yours and just hold tight to your side and smile like you've never seen in your life. I was very humbled by the perspective of the families when we were at dedication, and to listen to the family, what I keep calling our family. I felt like I showed you our family album today. I was beaming with pride, this connection with these people, and they're now my people. And to listen to the father didn't want to talk about the earthquake. He didn't want to share, because we believe they lost children in the earthquake. Because when we asked the mom for the agents of the children to provide them sleeping mats for their new home, she said, she listed them off and said, those are all of my children that are alive, the others are dead. And although we don't know when and where that would have happened, the fact that they didn't want to address it in the dedication to us, we felt that they more than likely lost some children there. And through all of that, the dad said, God has a purpose for everyone. He said, I know this because I never would have met any of you if he hadn't brought you from where you are to where I am and brought us together without a purpose and a plan. And so I give all glory to God for what has happened and what has transpired to bring you here today. And then at the other house, the woman who lost her husband 10 years prior was raising children on her own and barely escaped the earthquake with her life. And to look and to smile and said, it was by the grace of God. And they are so happy. They don't look at what they have is nothing. They look at the window picture with the palm trees and the mountain on the other side. That's looking out of their, what will be their living area. That's the view they have every day. That's what they see. They don't see what they don't have. They see what they do have. So it's very humbling to be part of that. It was also an honor and a privilege to be able to serve them, because I felt like they taught me far more than I ever could have shared with them. I've had a year of God experiences, and all of last week was one moment after the other. From the first minute I peeked outside the window to see the edge of Haiti coming into view from the airplane, I felt the hand of God reach into my heart and grab a hold. That is now my home. When I look at it and I see the people, I see my home. And I almost didn't get back on the plane. take very long before I can get back. The children are also an experience for me that I will never forget. But my biggest moment was when we were dedicating the middle house on the road. And you're standing there facing the new home. You've got the road right here, and on the other side of the road, it pitches down into a deep canyon. It comes straight up the other side, this huge, huge mountain terrace with gardens. And you go see on this side, get straight down, and same thing on the other side. You're just on a ridge between two majestic mountains. And it's, pictures will never do it justice, the beauty of it. And we talk and we set our piece, and we sang a little song. And the Haitians thanked us in return and started singing "How Great Thou Art." I can't explain that to you unless you're standing there to be able to see that and to feel that and feel the gratitude that these people have and the connection that they have. It also saddens me to know that in the midst of all of this, they know more of God than most of us will ever see. So I challenge you to think about that. Think about what differences do we make here for ourselves? How do we appreciate things differently? But how do we also find ways to give what we do have, the different pieces of ourselves? I have nothing to give of monetary value to anybody, but I know there are parts of me that I can give that will make a difference. Ironically, one of the first days I actually can check email this morning, and I had a quote in my inbox from Winston Churchill that said, "We make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we get."